Warm greetings. We are students from Kathmandu University studying computer engineering, and this video explains briefly about the recent research project we undertook on the topic localization of real-time sign language translating application for our course Human-Computer Interaction under the guidance of our instructor Sushil Shrestha. We would like to extend deep gratitude towards him for providing us with this wonderful opportunity. This research project focuses on creating a real-time sign language translating application based on Nepali Sign Language and its scope in Nepal. The team members include Merina Khimbalja, Jivite Shrestha, Swapnil Parajuli, and Utsav Prajapati. Did you know, like spoken language, sign language also differs in different countries, even different regions of the same country, and most of this technological translator are best in American Sign Language and rarely in Nepali Sign Language. Moreover, these translating applications are not real-time translators, but rather they have predefined database with animations and pictures of signs mapping to respective words, letters, and numbers. After analyzing the existing products, we read research paper on the success of such applications, things that are to be considered before implementing its challenges and outcomes. We took a survey amongst hearing people to know their best knowledge of sign language, technical translators, and opinions on such ideas. Among them, 51% of people were clueless that sign language differ from country, and only 32% were aware of it. Only 8% people have used translating applications, and among them, 55% of these applications were based on American Sign Language and 25% in Nepali Sign Language. 67% of them responded that there must be translating application in Nepal as well. We discussed the problem statement and our hypothetical solution with two group of friends who are taking the same course. We came into conclusion to make a real-time sign language translating application which takes signs as input, translates into letters, words and numbers and displays them on a screen. Before designing a technical translator, it was important for us to know what an actual human translator does. We also needed to dig deep into the feasibility of technical translators. Through our instructor, we virtually met Ms. Shulu Sharma, former president of National Association of Nepali Sign Language Interpreter. We learned a lot about hearing and speaking impaired community, linguistic approach of sign language, and duties of interpreter. With the help of a set of structured questions we designed prior to the interview, we decided to draw user personas of potential users. Our users are both hearing and hearing impaired people who want to communicate with each other in real time. Both the users are potentially Nepali who can make Nepali sign language, and the other is hearing Nepali person who can understand Nepali letters and numbers. Their goal is to communicate with each other, but the major issue is the language barrier. Our application gives them a common ground through which they can fluently converse regardless of language. Being visual or verbal, we made a paper prototype of our goal product. The window will have a green rectangular box at top right corner where you place your hands to give sign input. The translated letters and numbers are displayed on top left corner, concatenated words and numbers on bottom left. We took review of the prototype with same two group of friends and moved into development process. This is a short demonstration video of our initial product. It only contained Nepali alphabets from Ka to Ga. It had no provision of concatenation. After studying SAI, we learned about UX and its enhancement. Therefore, we added the functionality of concatenation of letters into simple Nepali words like kalama and numbers that are greater than 9 or now of Nepali numbering system. After finalizing our product, we virtually contacted Deaf Federation of Nepal. Since it was not possible for us to actually visit them and give demonstration of the product, we sent them a demonstration video of how our project worked. They appreciated the product but also hinted that technical translators had a long way to go. Facial expression and body language are crucial part of sign language and it should be inclusive in the project as well. The factors such as hand retention and hand shape are important aspects of Nepali sign language. We should take that into consideration as well. Since we trained the models ourselves, we suggested us to get an expert to train the model. We took a small survey among hearing people for severity satisfaction. We also sent the product to a friend with both hearing impaired parents. We got very positive feedback. Technology still has a long way to go for fluent conversation between hearing and hearing impaired people. We plan to develop it further. Thank you so much for watching this video.